The Couple Next Door, written by Peg Lynch and starring Peg Lynch and Alan Bunce.
The morning mail arrived already?
Yeah, nothing much, though. Just ads and bills, I guess. Here, postcard.
Move the butter, dear. You're getting a sleeve in it.
Yeah.
Oh, notice from the department store. The Christmas card books are in.
Christmas cards? Uh-huh. You kidding? For Pete's sake, already?
Well, it's August. Might be a good idea as long as we have a baby nurse and I have some free time right now to pick the cards now and get them addressed. For once, let's get them out early. We always say we're going to, and we're still addressing them Christmas Eve.
Yeah, well, I mean, you can't...
As I recall from last year, I made three lists. Our regular list, and then a list of people we sent to who didn't send any to us, and people who sent to us and we didn't send any to them. Now, there are about 300, I think.
300?
Yeah, 300, where the list keeps growing. Each year, we decide to cut down. Instead, we add about 25 more. Of course, about 125 of these dear business people, but this year, I really do think we should cut down, and I mean cut down.
Cut down? Look, let's just cut it out entirely.
Oh, well, honey,
no kidding, why don't we? Just not send any Christmas cards at all this year.
Well, we always say that, darling, and we always do.
All right, now let's make the decision and stick to it. The cards are expensive.
Let's pick out a cheaper card.
Darling, we always say that, then we always wind up with a card that costs much more than we ever intended to pay. Then we got all the work of addressing them, and you got to buy a stamp.
Well, let us face it, dear, you don't do much of the addressing.
I know, I know, I hate it. So save yourself some work. This year, let's not send Christmas cards, huh?
No, of course, it's nice to get them.
Look, darling, we open them, we look to see if there's a note on it or just a printed name, we stick it up on the mantelpiece for a week, and then we throw them out. I say, let's eliminate the whole thing this year, huh?
Last minute, we'll rush around frantically sending out cards we have to send, like business friends. And once you start, who are you going to leave out?
Hmm? Yeah, I don't know. Well, all right. Why do I talk? Pick out a card, whatever you decide's okay with me.
Oh, no, you don't.
Huh?
I did that last year, and when they arrived, you said, why would you ever have picked a card like this? I didn't hear the end of it. No, this year you're going with me.
Oh, darling, I hate to
You
go
said
down
yesterday
there.
You weren't too busy at the office this week. I'll meet you for a quick lunch, and we'll rush over to the department store and pick out a card.
Look, there's always a mob of hysterical women grabbing those books.
Not this early. It's August. I'll meet you at noon. For once, we're going to pick out our Christmas cards early.
Oh. Early every weekday evening, CBS Radio invites you on a guided tour of the world with Lowell Thomas. Personal friend to many of the world's leaders and a highly traveled personality himself, Lowell Thomas often knows the people who are making the news and knows the places where the news is being made. His CBS News reports are filled with facts and anecdotes he's gained at first hand. Join us on CBS Radio Monday through Friday when it's time for Lowell Thomas and the News. Another CBS News feature to hear regularly is The World Tonight. Seven nights a week, The World Tonight takes you anywhere in the world the important stories are breaking. It offers you eyewitness reports by our experienced overseas correspondents. It brings you lively interviews with people in the news. Every evening, meet the world halfway on CBS Radio as most of these same stations bring you The World Tonight.
Some little slips of paper and mark the pages that I like.
Oh,
the ones.
Golly,
excuse me, are you looking at this book?
Excuse me. No, ma'am. No, you can take it.
Thank you. George, come here.
Thought you said we'd be the only ones here.
Well, darling, I guess other people do pick their cards. Oh, look, isn't this, darling? Do you like this?
No, I do not.
Oh, it's darling. What don't you like about it?
I don't like anything about it, honey. Why do you always latch onto some card like this? I mean, a bunch of mice in red pajamas decorating a Christmas tree. It's absurd to begin with.
I think they're cute.
Honey, I've told you a dozen times. I have got to send our cards to business friends, too. I can't send a card with little mice on it to the president of a bank.
I don't know why you don't pick out regular business cards for those people the way other people do.
Donnie, it looks too commercial. I like something more personal.
Yes, I know, but I don't...
Oh, miss.
I'm sorry, madam, but I've got a customer.
Well, I just want to ask you a question. I saw a card early this morning, and I brought my husband back to look at it. It was a beautiful one with a pine cone on it. Now, which book would that be in?
Oh, madam, we have 45 books here, and quite a few of them have cards with pine cones on them. Now, if you'll just wait a minute, I'll help you look. Uh-huh. And in the meantime, you might look yourself and see...
But my husband has to get back to his office.
I'm sorry, madam. At the moment, I have a customer.
I have been shopping at this store for 24 years. Now, I certainly feel that I should get better service. Why don't they put more salespeople on in this department?
I don't know, madam. I have nothing to do with it.
Really? George, come over and help me look through this book. Oh, excuse me again. I think the book I want is right under the stack in front of you.
Oh, darling, it's on that tray. Look out, darling.
The service you get nowadays, you just don't care. And...
Yes, I know. Well,
darling,
you
look
know,
out. The books. Look out, dear. The books are...
Oh, I am so sorry. Oh, George, oh, George, right. I think the black hole is in this
Honey, are you hurt?
I don't think I'm going to walk again.
Oh, well, honey, don't make such a fuss.
Such a fuss? What are you talking about? Have you ever had one of those enormous Christmas card catalogs crash on your foot?
No, and I'm terribly sorry, darling. How do you like these with the little angels on them?
I do not like little angels.
Oh, they're kind of cute. Look at this, a cathedral window. Oh, isn't that beautiful? Now, that really looks Christmassy.
I broke my toe.
Can't say you don't like this one, dear.
I can certainly say I don't like the price of it. $1 per card? What are you talking about?
Oh, I didn't see that. Wouldn't you know?
I think I got two broken toes.
Oh, I don't think so, honey. Now, don't make such a fuss. Here, this is nice. Old-fashioned Christmas.
What's the matter with that woman?
The kitchen with the old wood range. Look at this, darling. Grandma cooking pie. Grandfather coming in from outside with a turkey, and through the window you can see the family arriving in a sleigh.
No.
Oh, I like that. Well, what do you like, dear?
I like a... Oh, my foot. I like a perfectly plain card that says Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
That doesn't show any imagination at all. Hand me that book over there, Winston. Let's look through.
Honey, I've got to get back to work. I can't
stay here. No, you don't. You've got plenty of time, and we're here, and I've got you, and we're going to pick out a card today.
Where's that woman? Oh, here. Honey, look, this isn't bad. Take that.
That one?
Yeah, that's very nice. Now, what's wrong with that, huh?
Well, there's nothing to it. It just says season's greetings.
Well?
Oh, no, dear. Let's pick a card that has some originality.
Not very expensive either,
I don't see any point sending a card at all if there's nothing to it at all.
Oh, well, that's okay, honey. That's what I said this morning. Let's not send any then, okay? How about that? Look, I've got to get back to the office.
Sit down, please. Look through that book right there. How do you like this one?
Hey, that one isn't bad. No, that one there.
Oh, I don't like that at all, dear.
Well, what don't you like about it?
Well, I don't know. It just doesn't do anything to me.
What's it supposed to do to you?
Well, I think when you look at a Christmas card, you should immediately get the feeling of Christmas. Something should sort of come over you, a sort of warm glow.
Aren't you asking an awful lot of a Christmas card?
Well, I don't think so. That's what usually happens.
Warm
I just keep
glow.
Looking and looking, and all of a sudden I see one, and I know instantly. That's the one, you know, just sort of hits me.
Well, the only thing that hits me is the bill. Where's that woman?
Oh, really? Why do we have to go through this every year?
I don't know, I'm sure. The idea of Christmas cards is a nice, friendly spirit, and by the time we've decided on one, we're usually at each other's throats.
I know it. I wonder if other married people have the same problem we do.
Oh, sure.
You think so? Sure. Here's a nice card.
I know so. In fact, honey, I think George is about to explode any minute.
Who is George?
George is the husband of that crazy woman that dropped the books on my foot. Look at him. Honey, let's move down a little. I don't want to miss the explosion.
Oh, honey, that's not nice to eavesdrop. Never mind. Dear, don't
come on,
let go of my arm.
Sweetie, here's some books down here we haven't seen.
George, I just wish you'd say whether you like it or not.
It's all right.
Oh, excuse me, would you? Could I just have this book, this one, under here?
Oh, yes, of course. Now, what does that mean, George? It's all right.
I mean it's all right. If I say all right, it means all right.
Well, do you like this card or don't you?
Look, what do you want me to say? I tell you every year the same thing. I'm tired of English stagecoaches. You get them anyway. Why do you drag me up here every year to get my opinion?
Well, I don't know what you want, I'm sure.
Just something that says Merry Christmas. Now, what's wrong with that? It's the idea of a Christmas card, isn't it?
See?
I appeal to this gentleman here. Uh-huh. That's the idea of a Christmas card, isn't it? Something that says Merry Christmas.
Oh, boy, I couldn't agree with you more.
Dear, you stay out of this.
Yeah, well, he's right, honey. That's what I always say.
But I tell my wife, every year, she comes home with an English stagecoach.
I know.
Horses racing through the countryside with guys in top hats and red jackets and long trumpets. And Tiny Tim singing God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen.
I've told you a million times it isn't God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. It's God Rest Ye Merry, comma, Gentlemen.
Okay, God Rest Ye Merry, comma, Gentlemen. But I'll bet you $10 to donuts this year you'll pick out another English stagecoach. And why? We've never even been to England.
Oh, all right. This year you pick out the card. Go on, go ahead. You pick out the card.
Not me. I'm going back to the office.
George, now wait a minute, George!
You see, Annie, we're not the only ones who have trouble selecting a Christmas card.
I guess not. Well, come on, there's a whole pile of books over here we haven't looked at.
Oh, boy, not me. I think old George there is the right idea. I'm going back to the office, too.
No,
look, honey, in the long run, let's face it, we never pick a card unless you like it, too.
I want a card we both like.
Darling, at this point, I don't care what you pick. I don't care if it's an octopus wearing sleigh bells or a kangaroo dressed up like Santa Claus. I will like it.
You're sure now?
Absolutely, I promise you, I will like it. Whatever Christmas card you select is all right with me.
Now, that is your last drink of water, Betsy. You go right to sleep, and I don't want another word out of you.
Oh, now, don't be too hard on her. It's a hot night. Probably
good night, dear.
Probably hard to get to sleep. Oh, I meant to tell you, Mother called me today.
Oh. Must have been important for her to call long distance.
Well, she, you know, she was wondering when we were baptizing the baby.
Oh, and what did you tell her?
Well, I said we hadn't picked a date yet.
Mm. You didn't tell her we hadn't even picked a name yet.
Honey, look, what's wrong with Chauncey? I mean, my dad would be thrilled, and well, we don't have to call him now.
I think it is terrible we haven't named the baby yet, and I'm sorry we can't agree on a name, but I will not name him Chauncey, and that is final. And apparently he won't get named until we have some meeting of the minds here. I'm not going to call him.
I wonder why it is. Actually, you and I have always gotten along so well, you know. Really, I mean, we agree on so many things. Mm-hmm. And every now and then there are some things that we're just poles apart.
I know it. Isn't it funny? Well, I still love you anyhow.
Yeah. Well, I love you too, darling.
But it is true that some decisions we really have the word. Oh, I picked out our Christmas card. Brought a sample card home to show you.
Oh, did you? Fine. Well, that's one thing settled anyhow.
Here it is. Well, why the face?
Well, why in Sam Hill did you pick this?
If you shoot your husband in a fit of temper, it's only third-degree murder, isn't it?
Darling, all I said was, why would you pick this?
You said anything I selected you would like. Anything.
I know, but, honey, what is this supposed to be? The oil fields of Texas? I mean, all the derricks?
It's an impressionistic painting of Christmas trees, designed especially for the Christmas season by a famous artist.
Oh, well, I never would have picked this.
Well, they're ordered with our names on them. 300. Never again. Next year, believe me, you will pick the card.
Well,
I'm
darling,
not gonna do it
again. Certainly don't see how you ever picked a thing like
you
this.
You said you...
Suspense, yours truly, Johnny Dollar, the FBI in Peace and War, Indictment, and Gunsmoke. All of these exciting dramatic shows come to you Sunday after Sunday on CBS Radio, and every one of them is a winner. For a change of pace from your own routine, join us on most of these same stations every Sunday as CBS Radio raises the curtain on suspense. Yours truly, Johnny Dollar, the FBI in Peace and War, Indictment, and Gunsmoke. 3 solid hours of action. The Couple Next Door is written by Peg Lynch and stars Peg Lynch and Alan Bunce, with Beatrice Pons, Maxine Stewart, and Joseph Julian, and is produced by Walter Hart. This is Stuart Metz, inviting you to listen again tomorrow for The Couple Next Door.